What's up guys, Jason here, and welcome to an updated tutorial on real-time edits for making your mic sound better while live streaming. Now, I know I did a video on this in the past, a couple months ago, and as with anything, I've learned and I've improved, and I really do think that, undisputably, the audio and the effect that you're hearing right now is better than that of the last video. So, I decided to do an update video on this to help y'all out that are streamers. So there's no reason to say anything else, let's just get right into these edits. So the two programs you're going to need to download and install are Voicemeeter Banana and Lighthost. Now we used Voicemeeter in the last video, this time we're using the Banana edition which just has some more features, but Voicemeeter is at its core just an input and output type deal. Takes in the audio from the mic, and then we can set it up with Lighthost to process that audio, and it comes out of the virtual audio cable, which is what you're gonna select once you get into your streaming service. You're gonna select virtual audio cable as the input, or as the mic. And Lighthost is what it sounds like. It's a Lighthost for our plugins. We're gonna install our plugins onto Lighthost, and it's just going to take in the audio from Voicemeeter, process it using those plugins, and send it right back. So it's kind of just like a platform to run our plugins on. But anyway, those are the two programs you're gonna need to download and get set up so we can get started with these edits. And as always, they're both linked down below. Getting into setup, we first need to launch Voicemeeter and configure a few things. It's not complicated at all, despite how many buttons and knobs there are on the interface. We really only mess with two sections actually, the far left and the far right. So the far left needs to be set to the mic input. So just click it and select the mic you're using. You can see I'm using the Toner Q9. Check out my review if you want. And underneath that in the controls, I didn't mess with anything except the color panel and the fader gain. So move the color panel dot to where I have it for a nice crisp and full sound signature. At least I think it sounds good. And I'd say hold off with the gain for now. You're gonna need to see how the plugins we use later affect the mic sound, and then come back and tweak the gain based off of that. On the far right, you're gonna make sure the hardware out is virtual audio cable. It should be the default, and that's it for that panel. Last but not least, in Voicemeeter, you'll need to go to Menu, then Options, and at the very bottom, click to enable in-one left and in-one right. That's kind of like one half of getting Voicemeeter to talk to Lighthost. But that's it for Voicemeeter. Besides, like I mentioned earlier, maybe coming back to tweak the volume after you mess with Lighthost and get the effects in. But besides that, we're done with everything we need to do here. Lighthost will live in your status bar once you've run it, so go ahead and click it. And as you can see, I've got several plugins installed and running right now. There's some housework to do first though, because by default, Lighthost can't talk to Voicemeeter. So in order to fix that, you'll need to go to Preferences and then set the audio device to Voicemeeter Insert Virtual ASIO and make sure everything else looks like it does on my screen. But all that's left now is making sure that the plugins are installed right and tweaked to how I want them. I'm not going to go through the install process since I've already made a video on that, but basically just download them from the links below, install them as I demonstrated it in that other video, and from Edit Plugins, and then Options after that, you can set Lighthost to scan and pick up those plugins from where they're located on your computer. Anyway, I got some extra plugins here that you don't need, being Auto-Tune and Tower Reverb. You can skip those unless you plan on doing live performances or singing or something on your stream, but the ones we do need for this effect are TDR Nova and TDR Kotelnikov, an equalizer and a compressor respectively. When combined, these plugins will crisp up our audio and then balance out the volume levels. So take a look at my settings on screen now for a starting point, or just copy them entirely if you want. And now Voicemeeter is working with these plugins through Lighthost. And that's it. You just gotta set your input on your streaming service to virtual audio cable, and it'll sound like my audio right now because of those live edits. So hopefully you enjoy these edits and think they sound better than just playing dry audio straight out of the mic. And also hope you're able to follow through with everything and hopefully be able to improve the quality of your own streaming audio. Besides that, thanks for being here today. And before I close out this video, if you're wondering what it would sound like if I had the auto-tune and the reverb enabled, then there you go. Thanks for being here today. I do appreciate you watching my videos, and if you enjoyed, subscribe down below, and I will see you in the next video. And the elephant in the room, in case you didn't notice it first off when I started this video and expect me to say something about it then, I did cut the perm off and we're back to just straight hair. Rest in peace. She lasted a good 6 months.